I spent 30 years at NASA, started out as a research engineer, and then I was selected as an astronaut and flew on 4 space shuttle missions. And the last 5.5 years I was there, I was the director of Johnson Space Center. My first 2 flights, we were studying the Earth's atmosphere, and so when you get up there, and when you see this very, very thin blue line, and you realize, okay, that's the only thing keeping people alive, you know, on the surface of the planet. If we didn't have that atmosphere, we would not have people. You certainly gain an appreciation for why it is that we need to understand changes that are going on and, you know, potential effects. I would say the other thing I really gained an appreciation for is just what it is that a team of people can accomplish through the course of my 4 space flights, but also the work I did later on as a manager and leader at NASA. You know, it was really an appreciation for there's literally nothing we can't accomplish if we put our minds to it. You look at large issues that either our country faces or the world face. And it can seem like, you know, how are we ever going to figure this out, or how are we going to ever overcome it? But I think if you do put it in context to say, we already know more about that problem than we knew about what it would take to land on the moon when we said we were going to do that. So it's not that these problems are intractable. It's a question of, do we have sort of the critical mass in terms of brain power and resources and focus and perseverance, just from the very first week at NASA, I saw so many more women than I had ever seen, you know, in a previous job or in graduate school or in undergraduate school. So it was clear to me from the very beginning that NASA had focused on trying to get more of a diverse workforce, because that doesn't happen by accident, believe me, in the STEM world. So it's kind of nice. But of course, as you looked higher up in the NASA, you know, leadership ranks, you really didn't see women at that time. And I think that is what changed over the time that I was at NASA, is not only were there women astronauts, but there were women that moved into all kinds of more visible positions.